Well, well. So you figured it out.
Yes.
I am what keeps you in this place. But was it blind rage that made you act, or have you truly understood who I am? Have you understood what drives you and determines your actions?
I don't know what you're talking about.
The salt corrodes your skin, and the water filling your lungs is cold. But you still haven't found it, child, have you?
Found what? Jespar? Is that you? Wait, I'm dreaming now. Apparently. I'm dreaming while dying under the ocean. That is creepy as hell. No matter how hard you pull, it doesn't move an inch.
Good to see you awake. How are you feeling?
Where are the others? Mr. Bartar? Calia? Dunwar?
Good question. The room was empty when I came here. Actually, that's quite weird, now that you mention it. The entire temple seemed kind of deserted.
But, what?
Probably a ceremony or something like that. Now, tell me, how are you holding up? I heard this trial's quite the feat. Apparently, some of the novices never wake up again.
Fine, I guess. Where are we?
In the temple. The Curarium, to be precise.
I've been there.
You were brought here when you were traveling with that Eichsen guy.
What?
I think the others are already awake, but I didn't want to leave you here, so I thought I'd just stay.
Where is he?
I mean, hey, you are a keeper of the first sigil now, aren't you? I believe congratulations are in order.
I am? Thanks.
Don't mention it. Bad, though, that this keeperness won't get you anywhere.
No?
Do you know why? Because you're pathetic. Simply pathetic.
Hey! Excuse me?
I said you are pathetic. At first, we believed it would be more exciting this time.
And you're not Jespar.
Now that we've seen the new prophet, our hopes are gone. You're a joke.
What?
Nobody who let his only friend kick the bucket.
As if you'd ever accept that. You humans are always so damn persistent, aren't you? Why? Why can't you just let go?
Because what? In the end, you are powerless, just as all those before you. And you, prophetess, you are the biggest joke of all.
Yeah, I thought you were nice, at least.
You are nothing but an urchin.
A weakling.
And a murderer.
What?
And that is why you will burn. All of you. The cleansing will happen, and there's nothing you can do to stop.
What the... Wait. I don't know what it's... I don't know if I'm dreaming or if this is real, but you're the ones behind it, aren't you? Why are you doing this? What have we done to you?
What have you done to us? You are so naive.
So tell me...
The world is an interplay of cause and effect, and the only logical consequence of your existence is annihilation. That's the way it was, and that's the way it's going to be. But enough of the banter, urchin. We wanted to meet you, and so we did. Even though the result is rather sobering.
Can't say I'm glad
now
to meet
wake
you.
Wake up. Keep on stumbling through the mist.
Okay, getting just a little bit deja vu here. My chest? Dunwar? Calia?
Thank Malphus. I was starting to think I was the only one.
Who was still alive?
How are you? You look exhausted.
Yeah, I had a bad dream. A nightmare. Or this is the dream. I don't know. I had something. Or am having something.
You did. That's probably one of the after effects of the potion. But it will pass, I'm sure of it. But it's good to see the Grandmaster was right after all. I woke up just a few hours earlier, and he was here in the meantime. He didn't doubt for a single second that you would make it. But I suppose mutual congratulations are in order. We made it. We passed the trial.
Good to hear. Good. I'm glad to see you're nice again, or... Well, that wasn't you. So does that make us keepers now?
Almost, yes. All that is left to do is to take the oath, and then Grandmaster Aranthiel will exalt us to the keepers of the first sigil. Speaking of whom, he also told me some things while you were asleep. About the Pyreans, about these dreams, and of course, about this... cycle.
Well, he told you all that, huh?
This is so bizarre, really. At first we're told out of nowhere that the gods have died, and now humanity is on the brink of extinction. This is a lot to take in.
Yeah, no kidding. He told me not to say anything. I figured, well, what do you make of all this? The cycle, this cleansing.
Hard to say. I never had those dreams the Grandmaster talked about, even though I'm magically gifted. But then again, I always had the feeling that the Red Madness was more than an ordinary disease.
You're lucky, then.
Well, I suppose all of this explains a lot. At least now I can understand why the Grandmaster was willing to break all the traditions of the Order just to get you exalted to be a Keeper. According to him, most of our battle against the Cycle will stand or fall with you.
Wonderful. I wish I could say that with the same conviction as him. To be honest, I don't really think I've understood all of what's happened to me yet. And that's a bit of an understatement, but that's the way I'm gonna put it.
Yes, I believe that. It's a great responsibility you've been given. And as impressive as your skills are, I would not want to change places with you.
So what's the next step?
Well, as I said, we both have to take the Holy Oath. You should talk to the Grandmaster as soon as you're ready. He's waiting for you in the Emporium.
We both? What about Dunwar? He is sleeping in that bed, isn't he? Not dead?
Right. Dunwar. The apothecary examined him about an hour ago, and it doesn't look good. It's likely that he'll never wake up again.
Wow. He will die? Can't say I liked him that much, but he doesn't deserve that.
No, in spite of everything. You know, Dunwar was one of those people who tried to gild their insecurity with boastful behavior. The reality is that he was the last of his bloodline, and his faith in the path and his destiny as a keeper were all that he had left. And who knows? Maybe he would have been a great help to the Order with the right guidance. But I guess Master Bartar's revelation was just too much for him. It's hard to be told that everything you've lived for was a lie.
Two souls. Dunwar was the last of his bloodline?
Yes. All of the Dalmordans fell victim to the Great Flesh Maggot Plague of 8215.
Oh, yeah.
Actually, it was almost sad to see him running around and boasting about his nobility, though everyone knew that without the help of the Order... he would have probably ended up living in a shack in the Undercity, if you can call that living.
You don't seem to be too shaken up over all of this, the death of the Lightborn, I mean.
Well, maybe I just don't show it as much. But yes, in a way, you're probably right. I suppose that's mainly due to the fact that to me, as opposed to Dunwar, the Order always stood for an idea. And an idea doesn't die with the one who first thought of it. Funny that the Grandmaster said nearly the same thing during the exaltation. Dunmar would have considered it blasphemy.
You talk about the Lightborn and their ideas as if they wouldn't have cost thousands of lives. They weren't as benevolent as you make them out to be.
That's true. A lot of crimes were committed during the Lightborn's reign, and I don't want to minimize that. But I also think a lot of those crimes were unavoidable, so to speak. Imagine you're the king of a small island, and one day your realm gets attacked by a fleet of Skarrag Reavers. The invasion catches you completely off guard, and within a few hours, the Reavers have advanced to the farmland, just a few feet from your city's main gates. And before you know it, you have to make a decision. Will you use the time that remains to entrench your army within the city's walls to have a better chance of surviving a siege? Or do you send them into the field to fight the Reavers there, knowing that there is only a slight chance to save the farmers, but a big risk that you will lose both the city and the farmers?
Depends on if you're a gambling person. That is a very good question. Take a chance in the open field. Have a good chance of perishing, and then... But then the farmer's blood wouldn't be on my hands. Or draw back in the city to be safe and have a big chance to save the entire realm than a small one to save a handful of farmers. Maybe the needs of the many outweigh the needs of the few? All right, it's one thing to gamble with my own life, but if I'm gambling with the lives of the entire realm versus a handful of farmers, I have a right, I have a justification, rather, to gamble with my own life, not with other people's lives. I think I draw back into the city. Better to have a bigger chance to save the entire realm than a small chance to save a handful of farmers.
That's one way to see it, yes. But what if your foray would have succeeded? What if you could have prevented the massacre in the farmlands? What I'm trying to say is, it doesn't matter what you do. There will be people who will despise you for your decision.
No.
If your attempt to rescue the farmers fails, you will be accused of having acted blindly and idealistically. And if you just stay in the city, they will say you didn't even try. Yeah. Of course, there's a small chance the foray might work, but should decisions like that really be made as if they were a game of dice? As I said, I don't mean to absolve the Lightborn of their crimes, but I'd wager my left hand that they had a lot of similar decisions to make.
That's the problem with ruling. That's the problem with being a ruler. You're always going to have people who are not fond of your decisions. You have to act towards the greater good, don't you? But a lot of people do not understand that, or they don't have your viewpoint, because they are not the rulers, and it's always easier to criticize those who you don't know and who are not you. But that is an interesting thought. Speaking of Dunmar, what was that thing in the ritual place all about? He called you a witch. He really attacked you there, and after you defended him.
I knew the question would come eventually. I suppose the answer depends on whether you're in the mood for some gloomy talk.
Why not?
Sooner or later, you'll hear it from someone else anyway, so why not from me first?
Yeah, I mean, I've had enough crazy things happen to me in the last few moments, hours, lifetime. For all I know, I'm on the bottom of the ocean dreaming this before I die. So, never mind, I'm rambling. I wouldn't have asked if I weren't interested, so go ahead.
As you wish. Where should I start? Maybe with the fact that I don't remember anything that happened before my sixth winter. I don't know where I was born, and I never got to know my parents.
Hmm. You don't remember? Why?
I wish I knew. What I do know, though, is that the first memory I have is of waking up in the middle of some village. It was dark, and I felt dizzy, and, I don't know, empty? That's probably the best way to describe it. I eventually found the strength to get up and look around, and, well, that's when I realized what was actually going on around me.
What was going on around you?
The entire village. It had been destroyed. There were corpses everywhere. Men, women, children. And the houses had been crushed as if some mad god had rampaged through the streets there. And it had all just happened hours before because the destruction was still fresh. Whatever it was, I didn't have much time to think about it. As soon as I got up, I saw three riders coming through the smoke. One of them got off his horse, ran towards one of the corpses, and started screaming something in my direction. Then I felt a blow on the back of my head, and I lost consciousness. By the name of the sun, it's strange to talk about it like this. It's been so long, but the memory feels as if it had happened yesterday.
Was he yelling at somebody to attack you, or is he warning you of someone coming up from behind who is going to attack you? Well, in any case, someone came up from behind and attacked you. Why?
Well, it turned out the riders were hunters who had come from that village.
Hunters?
They must have observed the whatever it was from the distance and ridden back to the village. At least I think that's how it went. I guess I'll never find out. The reason they thought I was somehow involved is that the village priest found me a couple of days before it happened near a shrine in the wilderness. Apparently, I was wearing torn clothing, and no matter what the apothecary tried, he couldn't wake me up from my comatose sleep. And it seems that made the writers think I was some kind of witch child, or unholy beast, whichever you prefer.
So, they really thought a 6-year-old child destroyed an entire village? That's ridiculous.
For you, maybe. For them, as simple people, it was probably the best explanation they had. And think about it, it's not that far off. A motherless child who neither talks nor breathes steadily is found abandoned on the roadside and has a strange mark on her face. They leave to go hunting, and when they come back, they find their village in ruins, with that foundling child being the only survivor. You have to admit, it's not that much of a stretch. Even if those men hadn't been superstitious farmers.
So these men wanted to do what, exactly? Take revenge on you?
Probably. Truth be told, I try not to think about it too much. And actually, it doesn't matter, because I somehow managed to get away before they could do anything. I even made it to Ark all by myself. Which didn't turn out to be much of an improvement in the end, because I was pathless.
Hmm. They brought you into the Undercity, right?
Yes. Thinking about it now, I actually wonder how I made it through my time down there. But maybe that's one of the advantages of being a child. You don't think. You just act. Still, the winters down there were cruel, and if Master Tyrus hadn't found and taken care of me, I probably wouldn't have made it through my second year.
Master Tyrus? A keeper adopted you?
Yes. Otherwise, I would not be here. He saw me, and he knew what he had to do, is how he put it. Of course, the Order wasn't too happy about a pathless child in the Scuola, just as some aren't happy about you being here. But Tyrus was a highly regarded man, and that's why they let it slide.
So he just saw you and decided to adopt you? That sounds too good to be true, to be honest.
It does, yes. But then, he had lost both his wife and daughter 5 years before he found me, so maybe I was some kind of substitute. I don't know. But in the end, it doesn't matter. I owe him everything. He was a good man, and that's all that matters.
Was. So, he's no longer among the living, I suppose? Why is the Order so preoccupied about Pathless trying to get into their ranks? It's not like we both don't have our reasons.
That's right, we do. But we are both still Pathless. And that disqualifies us according to the Holy Verses.
Oh, screw the Holy Verses.
I guess now you understand why I was never as connected to Malphus's teaching as Dunwar was. To some of the Keepers, I am still an outcast. And no matter what I do, I always will be.
So Master Tyrus granted you the novitiate.
Yes. And now I'm here. Well, here we've reached the end of my impressive tale. I hope you liked it.
You're definitely not the fisherman's daughter from the village. I'll give you that.
No. I guess I'm not.
What happened to Master Tyrus? Where is he now? Yes, he's talking about him in the past tense, so he's not among the living.
Gone. He was very old, and there was nothing anyone could do about it. But I'd prefer not to talk about it, if you don't mind.
Of course. Of course not. Of course I don't mind. So that means Dunwar believes that this story about you being responsible for the destruction of that entire village, he believes that story is actually true?
He does, yes, and he's not alone in his opinion. One of those hunters recognized me in the market my first year as a novice, and you can imagine that it was easy pickings for those who were already against my presence in the Order. From then on, they added names to the derogatory stares. Demon child, witch, whatever they could come up with.
Well, this much is true. But I don't think that would be enough for novices to envy her. Because I'm sure other novices are talented, intelligent, and pretty as well. But I saw your skills, and you're the only one who made it through the trial. The way they treat you probably has more to do with jealousy than anything else.
Maybe. But everything I'm capable of is the fruit of hard work. Though they will never acknowledge that. You know what's funny? To some extent, I'm glad to be who I am. That way, people just leave me alone, and that gives me more time to focus on what's important. On my goals.
Sounds good. Sounds like a way to go. I mean, you really can't help the way others behave. You can only help yourself. You can only control your own actions. But your goals would be what?
Several. But I'd say that's enough of the gloomy stories, don't you think? There will be plenty of time for chatter in the future. Maybe.
Maybe. Did we go into this? Dunwar was the last of his bloodline?
Yes. All of the Dalmorans...
Oh, yeah.
Actually, it was almost sad to see him running around and boasting about his nobility, though everyone knew that without the help of the Order, he would have probably ended up living in a shack in the Undercity. If you can call that living.
Let's talk later. I should go see the Grandmaster now.
You should. It's already late, but if you want, I can show you the most important places in the temple before you go to the Emporium. What do you think?
That'd be nice.
Good. Then get your gear from the chest by your bed, and we'll go.
Part of something momentous. So I still don't have my stuff. And I don't have all the human flesh and human hearts that I grabbed from that dream or that reality, and this is the dream, or they're just different realities. No spoilers, please, guys, but I don't know. In my past life, I killed my entire family, or I killed my entire family and I'm dreaming that I didn't, or something. I don't know.
You should reclaim your gear before we leave.
Yeah, I'm gonna do that. Bloody rags. Alright, I am gonna reclaim my gear. Soon. What is this behind me? Is that embroidered? Can't read it. Well, can I? I can almost read that. Poor guy. Really didn't like him, but yeah, I don't think he deserved that. Oh, you never know. Maybe he did. So I am going to call in an episode here, guys. Thanks so much for watching, and tune in next time, and Alright, I survived the trial. All Calia and I have to do now is take the Holy Oath, which is promoting us to Keepers of the First Signet. I should talk to Taylor, Aranthiel, and the Emporium. I need to take my equipment back from the chest, so that's where my stuff is. So I need to get equipped again, and then she'll give me a tour around here, and then we'll talk to Aranthiel. So that'll be next episode. Thanks so much for watching, guys. And always, seek adventure.